fuck. Lighting is not on fleek. Let me turn it off. That's better. I'm just trying to be more professional and shit. How's it going, Dazzlers? I missed. Try it again. Welcome back to Daz Games. I've never missed before. You let me down, guitars. Welcome back to the second Q&A. About a week ago, I asked you on Twitter to use the hashtag AskDaz, and I'll be doing a second Q&A as you guys really wanted another one because you're that interested in my life. So let's kick it off. Whatever the fuck that was. Andy asks, if you could have two superpowers, what would they be and why? And this is technically two questions, Andy. What would you use them for? I assume you mean good or evil. My two superpowers would be, I don't want to say it. I was gonna say the ability to see every woman naked, but that's perverted. Still fucking cool though. I know, I'd like to fly. That would just be amazing. I mean, you just look out your window one morning and all you would see is, I would do that. And also invisibility, because who the hell would not want to be invisible? You know, you could just sneak into the cinema and is that really what I would use invisibility for? I wouldn't. I'd go behind someone and tell them and go, wah. And I'd probably use them for a mixture of good and evil, Andy, because making people jump is kind of evil in my book. Casey Jones asks, you could be any mythical creature. Which one would you be? A unicorn! It's just a Pringle pot. I don't have any good props to be a unicorn. Oh shit. Kate asks, what's your favorite Mexican food?
Burritos and tacos and fajitas.
I'm sorry I can't just answer a fucking question straightforward. That was probably really racist and I apologize. Fuck, I forgot the name again. Another Katie asks, what inspired you to start a gaming channel and Vine? Well, I've already answered the Vine question in my previous one. I discovered Vine through another YouTuber and I just went for it. What inspired me to do a gaming channel is you guys. I've always enjoyed games. I was literally in the womb playing. I was born with a damn controller in my hands. And so I figured you guys really wanted me to do a gaming channel. You kept asking me, so I did it. And it was you guys. I'm doing it for you guys and I love it. It's so much fun. I Want Food asks, can you do a sassy duck impression? That wasn't even a duck, was it? What the fuck was that? What do you want from me? Danielle asks, have you ever been to Amsterdam? No, but I'm gonna. Bethany asks, hey Daz, hope your day is good. It's not actually, Bethany, it's raining outside. It's Britain, it's quite bad. But she asks, what kind of tea do you drink? Now, ever since the, you know, tea party vines, you guys have been obsessed with what tea I drink. And I don't know why. I drink PG Tips. It is the ultimate tea. There, nothing compares. There's all these other different things that people say, oh no, PG Tips, it's common drink. It's not, it's the best tea. And I think the Queen drinks PG Tips, so Simonson asks, how did you come up with the name Daz? Well, I didn't come up with it actually. What happened, Simon, is I was born and then my parents were like, what the fuck are we gonna call this thing? And they decided to call me Daz. It's my name. That probably came across a little sarcastic. My name is Darren, but everyone calls me Daz. And when I got a PlayStation account, I didn't know what to call my account, and I called it Daz_Black. That was just my PSN name. And since then, I've used it on everything, and I used it for my Vine account when I started up, so Daz Black. It's a shortening of my names. My real name is Darren Blackmore, so Daz Black. It's shortened of both my names, and that's it. Claire Saunders asks, how do you like your tea? In a cup. I like it hot, I don't like it cold. I can't drink it too hot, so I let it cool down a bit, but I have two sugars Milk, quite strong, don't like it too weak. My wife makes tea like it's fucking albino, or bino, or however you pronounce that word. Mzai Clark asks, I hope I pronounced that right. If you were female, what would be the first thing that you do? I'm not gonna answer honestly, because my honest thing is I would wear a white long dress, I'd wait for it to rain, and I'd run out in the rain and get wet and then come in and get... What the fuck is the matter with me? Seriously. Mzai Clark asks another question, and I'm going to answer this one because it's one that I think I should. Would you recommend to anyone buying a gaming PC? See, there's this stigma attached to PC gamers, that they're all snobs, and for the most part, that's how they sound. I've been a console gamer my whole life, and I love consoles. I'd never diss consoles. They produce some amazing games. All my gaming memories literally have been on them. But a gaming PC, since I've had one, I'm now buying all my games on it. You can use a controller if you want to, but I actually prefer the mouse and keyboard combo. But it's just, the games are cheaper on there. Console versions, they charge like 60, 70 pounds or something ridiculous. And you can pick them up for like £19.99 or £30 at the most. That's the special editions. You can buy the special editions for like £30. It's cheaper. Yet there are mods so that game's life expectancy is longer. The graphics are always, you know, going to be the best. And you're going to get the best experience from a gaming PC. But I understand that not everyone can afford it. So, I would recommend getting one if you can. It will blow your mind. Sean asks, what is the name of the song at the end of your gaming videos? I assume you mean the Skyrim dubstep remix. Little confession. I found it on YouTube. It was made royalty free and it said, you know, download and use whatever the hell you want. And people have been asking, what is the bloody song? Apparently, because they probably want it. I am trying to find it. I can't find it. I think they might have taken the video down after a load of people downloaded it. Maybe they thought, oh shit, maybe we can get some fucking money on this. But I'll find it and I'll let you guys know. I'm gonna go read the other comment now because PC's over there. At Pickle Tomlinson. What fucking name is that? At Pickle Tomlinson. That's probably your name, actually, isn't it? I'm not laughing. At Pickle Tomlinson. Fuck's sake. Oh, God, I'm so mean. Tomlinson asks, can you twerk? Can I twerk? Is that serious? I can twerk, damn it. I look like a duck that can't swim. What's that? Oh, fuck, I'm getting down. Fuck that. So yeah, to answer your question quite simply, I can't fucking twerk. And change your name. It's too funny. Jack asks, if you were a soup, what kind of soup would you be? Tomato. It's the best soup in the world. Henning asks, do you believe in God? Right, Daz, this is the time you need to not make a joke, because this is religion and... dodgy! My personal belief is, this is my opinion, and I respect everyone's opinion to believe in God and whatever they want to believe in, okay? I've said that before, I've said what I'm about to say. I do not believe in God. I'm actually... whether that makes me an atheist or whatever class that puts me in, I just don't believe in a God. I believe you're born, you die, whatever happens after that, if I go to heaven, great, if I just don't, if I come back as Kim Kardashian's panties, God, I hope not. I don't know what's gonna happen, I don't know if there's a big man sitting up there on the clouds, and if there is, then, you know, that's a really fucking boring job. I could get into this more about why I don't believe in religion. I'm not going to, because I know I will offend people, so now I don't believe in God, but that's my beliefs, and I think I'm entitled to believe what I want. Ethan asks, do you know where Hogwarts is? Yeah, that they actually got the location wrong in the movie. It's right through there. If you run at that wall, you'll go to Hogwarts. Take you straight there. You don't believe me? You think I'm lying? I'm British, okay? We invented that shit. Hogwarts is, I'm gonna show you. Oh, fuck, no it isn't. Yeah, I don't know where Hogwarts is. I think it's at a train station or some shit. Jess, fuck, that really hurt my arm. Hogwarts is a hard place to get on. It's like, I'm not OCD. Jess asks, is that her name? Fuck. Jess asks, if the world was about to end, what would be the last thing you'd do? I would make Jennifer Lawrence get a Twitter so I could harass her one, or for the first time, because she doesn't have Twitter. Fuck's sake. Screw it, I would track down Jennifer Lawrence and I'd get her to marry me and open up a Twitter page. Come on, Jen! Get the fucking program. GamerJB asks, can I come? I have cakes. It's not really a question, JB. I'm not currently planning any events that you can bring cakes to. But if I can think of one, then I'll let you know. Emmeline asks, I hope I pronounced that right. I'm dyslexic, I apologize. What is something really nerdy about you that none of us know, and what century would you rather live in other than this one? Something really nerdy about me that you don't know. I'm really am an open book. I don't think there's much you don't know about. Other century I'd live in? This one, to be honest. Other people, Johnny Depp once said, I'd much rather live in 13th century France. Johnny, do you know what it was like back then? You were lucky if you didn't wake up with a rat protruding from your asshole. There was no medicine. If your leg hurt, they fucking cut it off with a saw. You only had a bit of wood to bite down on. I'm grabbing this one. If I break my leg, I want to go to the hospital and be knocked the fuck out whilst they put it right. Dale asks, Daz, do you regret anything in life? Everyone has their regrets. There's a few things I regret in life. But I regret one time I stole a can of Fanta and a chocolate bar from a shop, and that's mean shop apparently. And I got outside and I realized they were out of date and I felt done, over. I wanted to take them back. Can you imagine it? Excuse me, sir. I stole this from your shop and it's out of date. Stop with that. I only steal the best, sir. Chris Patterson asks, have you ever been to the States? No, I haven't been to the States. And I want to, I need to, I really want to get over to the States. It's been my lifelong ambition to go to the States, see everything, everything. I want to travel around the US, and with all upcoming like film opportunities and stuff, that might be a possibility, guys. But when I am coming to the US, I'll let you know and we'll all meet up and we'll do some shit. James asks, why do you play games in your wardrobe? I'm getting this question all the time, and I'm so glad that you answered it, James. I'm gonna show you that I'm not in the wardrobe, okay? It's just behind me, come here. Oh, it's like we're dancing. Yep, that's the face I make when I dance. If you look over here, here is my setup. It's a bit messy, so I had to chuck shit. It's my setup here in the corner, my desk, my PC, here. Fucking dust on that! Look at it! And the wardrobe, as you can see, is right behind me. It's like, you know, that's a box full of shit. Matt, I really need to tidy my room. So I'm not in the wardrobe, it's just behind me. And it just looks like I'm playing in the closet. But I'm not, what the fuck was that? Becky asks, if you could play a real life version of any game, what would it be? Ooh, that's good. My favorite game is The Last of Us, but I would not want to be in that world. Screw that. Probably Tomb Raider. I'd like go with Lara Croft and raid some tombs. That'd be pretty cool. I love her. Livy asks, do you like the movie Frozen?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say! No. Sydney asks, who is your favorite superhero? You, Sydney. Rye Rocks asks, what the fucking name is that? What is your real job away from YouTube? I get this question a lot. You're like, what is your real job? This is my real job. I've had so many jobs. I've worked in factory shops, call centers, KFC, I serve chicken! But I now do this. This is how I now make a living. And Like I say, my last job was in construction, carpentry, bricklaying, blah, blah, blah. But I now do this. Since you guys follow me and you love my videos, this is what I do. I love it. I've always wanted to entertain. I've always wanted to be an actor. And now I'm getting these opportunities. And it is all because of you guys. And thank you so much. All jokes aside, thank you. I love you. Come here. Just. And now you're all gonna unsubscribe because I just tried to rape you. That's great. Gordaska asks, ow. What was your first reaction when you found out you were having a child? No, I'm joking. I was a bit scared. I think all men are a bit scared when they find out they have a baby because they're a huge responsibility and it's life-changing. You just don't know what to expect. My main concern was that I was gonna break her, because when she was born, she was so tiny, she was like that, you're a little boy. And I was asking nurse, like, am I holding her right? Is this how you do it? Can I put her there? Can I put her there? Can I fucking put her there? Fucking wear her as a hat? I didn't do that. Insanity Shorts asks, do a dance for me. I'm not gonna dance for you. Why would I? Not sure what this dance move is. I look like an elephant trying to be sexy. Valencia asks, why are you so fabulous? Sweetie, I don't know. Like, I was just born and then. I don't know. Okay, Dazzlers, that's all I've got time for. I had loads more questions asked, but I just couldn't fit them all in, as you can understand. But we'll do this again. We're doing Ask Dazz 3. Follow me on Twitter, links down below, and on Instagram, and that's where I usually post hashtag Ask Dazz when it happens. And yeah, I just burped.
Stay subscribed to my YouTube channel. Catch you later, amigo.